On Tuesday, two youngsters continue their learning process in the first team. 18-year-old Stephen Craney is a starter for the fourth time. Also keeping his place is Irish under-21 international Colin Healy. Keeping the age average down is 19-year-old Mark Burchill. The Scotland striker has scored in three of the last four games to take his season's total to 11. When Aberdeen lost seven goals here in October, Jim Leighton was blameless. David Priest was in goals. Since then, Leighton's been reinstalled as number one. The Aberdeen team shows four changes after the midweek defeat at St Johnstone. The absence due injury of Russell Anderson is countered by the return of Cato Gundveit and Andy Dow, who were rested, and Jamie McAllister, who's fit again. Mark Perry's in too. Young, Lily and Bellabed step down. The starting lineup again doesn't include Morocco and Hisham Zerouali, but there is another chance for David Rowson to show he's worth a new deal when his contract runs out in the summer. The referee for Celtic against Aberdeen is Kenny Clark. Celtic kick off in bright sunshine, and their goal difference over Aberdeen this season looks pretty bright too. In four games, which include the League Cup final, they've struck 20 times against Aberdeen without reply. The visitors will hope they can narrow the gap this afternoon and put themselves in a little bit better shape for the 10th Scottish Cup final, which is now just 3 weeks away. Stubs to Berkovic. Reset to Mahe. Held up by Johnson, but couldn't find the layoff for either Berkovic or Mahe. That's overrun by Jamie McAllister. In stepped Colin Healy, gets it back from Johnson. Tommy Johnson again, mishit the shot, got himself into a good position, and he was well set up as well by Healy. Now it's the other youngster, Craney. Maravchik, Berkovic, gets the return from Johnson. And just wide from Mark Burchill. The best chance of the match so far with 3 minutes gone. Good exchange. Played in by Berkovic. And Mark Burchill will look upon this as a great chance missed. Not picked up. Derek White wasn't close. And for Burchill, the shot ruffled the wrong side of the net.
Maravchik combining with Berkovic. Now Lambert and Healy. Berkovic again, good pass from Maravchik. Craney on the outside, he's made a good run. Celtic's first corner, one by the youngster, conceded by Gundveit and taken quickly for Berkovic.
Burchill with a second chance,
blazed it too high, possibly surprised that the ball broke back to him, but really wanted to hit the target there. Short with the pass was Maravchik. It was intended for Berkovic, but Aberdeen have lost possession too. Now the combination works. Did it quite standing firm, but distribution poor. The ball handed back to Celtic. Lambert blocked by Rowson. Reset trying his best to find a way past Jamie McAllister. Quick with the throw for Healy. Corner kick. Off White. Quick thinking from Reset. And Healy was alive to the possibilities too. Alan Stubbs, marked by Thomas Solberg in the penalty box. In from Maravchik, and Jim Leighton lost that completely. A Another chance for Celtic. Jim Leighton came for the cross, lost it, and he was grateful to Andy Dow to nod it off the line. Good pass from Moravcik. Lambert to Creaney. His pass blocked by Mark Perry. Cleared away by Gundveit and took a knock as he did so. Kato Gundveit hobbles towards the touchline. Here's how he was hurt. Played the ball away, and it was Mark Burchill who caught him in his follow-through. Aberdeen forced into making a change after just 16 minutes. Derek Young comes on, the injured Kato Gundveit unable to continue. Paul Lambert, Luba Moravcik, almost made it through for Johnson. Signs of frustration around Celtic Park. They've had so much of the game so far, still to make a breakthrough. Aberdeen committing players forward. Winters with the pass, and Andy Dow with the shot. Not too menacing for Stuart Kerr. But from an Aberdeen point of view, I make this the first shot at goal. Tommy Johnson, not quite. Moravcik have made a good run. Bresson's clearance only as far as Lambert, and now Berkovic. Greeny's cross, beyond Virchow and into the hands of Leighton. Played that straight to Colin Healy, did Robbie Winters. Free kick given against Andy Dow's challenge on Vidar Reset. There was a trip. Stefan Mai pushes forward. Moravcik in possession. Onto the right foot, good hit. Jim Leighton very solidly behind it. Well positioned and good handling. This was well struck. Lambert's pass to Johnson. Still has it, Tommy Johnson. Good play! Minutes gone, and a DIY effort from Johnson, who was strong enough to hold off the challenges, find himself a glimmer of light, and then fire a shot beyond Jim Leighton. Tommy Johnson's ninth goal of the season, and this just his seventh starting match. Healy held off McAllister. Moravcik with the reverse pass for Burchill. Tried to work that onto his left foot. And the danger was cut out by Thomas Solberg. This looked like a good opportunity for a second Celtic goal. Good quality on the pass from Moravcik. Not quite for Burchill. Berkovic with Healy alongside him. That's for Johnson. Loaded down for Moravcik. McAllister had the chance to clear, didn't do so. And it's Berkovic. Good save. Jim Leighton. If he'd given it a little bit more power, Berkovic, that might well have found the net, because it was a good angle. It stretched Leighton. but it lacked a little bit of pace. All that after McAllister's mistake. But Aberdeen lacking any sort of attacking ideas. Celtic couldn't have wished to have seen more of possession. Craney for Berkovic. And Stephen Craney again. Moravcik this time on the right foot. It's a blunder by Jim Leighton, and it presents Luba Moravcik with Celtic's second goal. 34 minutes gone, and Jim Leighton doesn't need told that he should have been able to handle this shot. It spun up off his chest, and agonizingly for him, it dropped inside the post. Well enough hit from Moravcik, but it shouldn't have been a problem. It bounced back off the chest of Leighton, then hit his glove, spun back over his shoulder, and Leighton was beaten. Johnson quickly on for Mark Burchill. Here's a chance for the third goal. And the combination of Solberg and Leighton keep out the teenager. This was a good run and a good quick pass from Tommy Johnson. The Aberdeen defence opened up. Vida Wieset up in the box. In from Berkovic. Header from Alan Stubbs, just too high. Won it well enough at the set piece, pretty much unchallenged Stubbs, but he couldn't keep the header down. Rousen's pass. Couldn't get on the end of it, and now trudges backwards in pursuit of Colin Healy. Good run from Healy, and a good save by Jim Leighton. Saw the opportunity opening up for his second top team goal, scored at Dens Park earlier in the season, and this was good goalkeeping, good reactions from Leighton to deny the youngster. Berkovic. Craney's up and about. Moravcik. Mahi. Now Berkovic. Now Mahi. And it's wide. Well set up, Stefan Mahi, by this delicate little flick from Berkovic. Inviting for the left foot volley. Flew wide. Wieset beat Winters without too many problems. Now Moravcik. No chance for Jim Leighton this time. A big slice of good fortune about Luba Moravcik's first goal, but no doubts about this one. Through the legs firstly of Solberg, and then a rasping left foot shot into the roof of the net, and Celtic 3-0 up. Celtic unstoppable in this first half, and this just about sums it up. Solberg beaten with so much ease, and then Jim Leighton was left to admire the shot. 3-0, a minute left in the first half. Johnson, whose goal started it all off for Celtic. Craney halted. And the first half halted with a half-time whistle. It's 23 goals now without reply for Celtic against Aberdeen this season. The first of the day scored by Tommy Johnson, followed by a blunder by Jim Leighton, which allowed Luba Moravcik to make it 2, Again, it was Moravcik again who hammered in the third goal of a Celtic-dominated first half.
This was number one, all down to the tenacity, the determination of Johnson. And then, seeing the gap, fired in the shot, which had the beating of Jim Leighton. The veteran goalkeeper should certainly have done better with number two. He knows it, doesn't he, told. The shot from Moravcik fired into his chest, but it bounced back from his chest onto his hands, and from there it spun into the net. Aberdeen two down. And it was Moravcik again, with just a minute left in the first half, who added yet more punishment through the legs of Solberg, and a fiercely hit shot, and this time Jim Leighton was blameless. Celtic cruising and unchallenged, and the only question now is how many goals will they score in the second half. It's 3-0 at half-time. Aberdeen make an immediate change after the turnaround, and it's Hisham Zerawali who is on, and Ariel Stavrum is off.
Aberdeen will be delighted to know that goals lost in the SPL this season for them have now reached 80. And 21 of those inflicted by Celtic. And there's still 45 minutes of this match left. No contest so far. One ball from Mahé. Skids away from Birchall through to Leighton. Bernard's pass through the middle, chased by Rousen, a chance to pull a goal back. A glaring miss by David Rousen. That would have given Aberdeen at least some faint hope in the second half, but that was a poor effort pulling a goal back. An easy stop for Kerr. Lambert has it. Down, Zerawali away from stumps. Another chance for Aberdeen. Zerawali might well have chosen to go it alone there. He tried to play in Robbie Winters, but that was one he could have taken himself. McAllister continues the run, and Larson held off by Mahé. Milkovic, Johnson's onside. Away from Derek White. It's number four. Two for Johnson. Celtic waste no time in the second half in stretching their leads. 5.5 minutes after the restart, and Johnson does it again, cutting inside. Jim Leighton got his hands to it, but he couldn't prevent this reaching the far corner. And this could turn into a total rout. 5-0, 7-0, 6-0 in the league, now 4-0. Winters' flick finds Rousen. Zerawali wants it. A forgettable effort from the Moroccan. It's one youngster for another for Celtic. Off goes 18-year-old Stephen Craney. On comes 16-year-old John Kennedy. Birchall, inside, then outside. It's a good run from Birchall. And it's Johnson!
That's the hat-trick. A moment of joy for Johnson. And there must be deep despair in the Aberdeen defence. There were chances to clear it. Virgil started the problems for Aberdeen when he got in behind Derek White. But there was a chance for Perry to get rid of the ball. Instead, he lofted it up for Tommy Johnson. And he accepted the opportunity with some glee. So Tommy Johnson's tally now for the season on to 11. It's 5-0. Reset, Johnson, Virgil, stopped by Solberg. Berkovic, fouled by Bernard. But would do well to let Kenny Clark take care of business. I think that's the message from the referee. It was, though, a heavy challenge. And late from Paul Bernard. And he's very fortunate to escape without the yellow card there. Johnson, after a change of shorts, back in action, Mahi, it breaks for Johnson again on the left foot. Too high this time. He certainly had the opportunities, has Johnson, taken three of them already. Poor pass from Zerawali. Stubbs on the interception through Moravcik to Berkovic. And Moravcik again. Great chance for his hat-trick. He was a little bit lazy as the ball came to him. He leant back and that meant the shot flew over the top. Side, Robbie Winters. Can Aberdeen pull the goal back? Yes, they can. This time, the chance is taken. It won't make an awful lot of difference to the outcome, but it's put smiles on those faces for a brief couple of moments. Played through by Derek Young, the offside trap beaten, and Stuart Kerr beaten as well, as Winters walks round him. So for the first time this season, this is a momentous goal because it's the first goal Aberdeen have scored against Celtic all season. But it is 25-1 in total. Ryson stopped by Stubbs. Paris Clevens. Aberdeen back in possession with Bernard and McAllister. Winters. Good effort from Robbie Winters. Having pulled a goal back, fancied himself for another one. Long range this time. And that didn't look too far away. Kennedy. Kerry loses possession. Shields leaves it to Moravcik. Good effort. Unexpected from that sort of position, the corner of the penalty box. And I suppose nothing should be unexpected when it's Lubo Moravcik responsible. Good save by Jim Leighton. He was taken by surprise. Winters, driven in, deflected, away from Zerawali and touched away from Andy Dow as well by Colin Healy. This was an important touch from the youngster. Dow looked as if he might well be able to pull another goal back until Colin Healy's arrival. Celtic lift the pace with Berkovic. pass intended for Shields. Cut out by White.
Young was being fouled by Mahe. Winters against Kennedy. Andy Dow. And a good save by Stuart Kerr. Denies Derek Young. Tried to place this with the right instep. It was curling in at the far post as well. Good save by Kerr. There was no way past Bobby Petter for Derek Young. Free kick given. In from Andy Dow. A header across goal, and Zedewale couldn't keep the shot down. It was Paul Bernard who ghosted in at the far post, sent the header across, and from less than 6 yards out, the Moroccan blazed a shot over the top. A long raking pass from Alan Stubbs, which finds Ayle Berkovic. The back heel for Johnson. Kerry away. Healy. Berkovic. Celtic claim a penalty against Mark Perry. The claims waved away by Kenny Clark. Celtic fancied themselves for goal number six. The shot into the ground from Berkovic, and there was the arm used by Perry. And Aberdeen very fortunate that a penalty wasn't given there. With the layoff, he was then unceremoniously decked. Berkovic for Maravchuk. Lovely skill from Maravchuk, and a good tackle by Derek White. He looked beaten here, White, but he certainly hadn't given up, and he had the last say with that tackle. Reset, Moravcik, Berkovic, stumbled at the key moment, but he does get a free kick. There was a foul there by Perry. Johnson's there, Berkovic as well, Stubbs alongside. Berkovic, too high. He wanted that to dip a little bit quicker. And Kenny Clark says that's enough. Full time. And Celtic have cruised home by 5-1. The overall goals tally between Celtic and Aberdeen for the season is 25 Celtic and 1 to Aberdeen. 3 of them this afternoon, claimed by Tommy Johnson. 2 scored by Lubo Moravcik. And really, it was all too easy for Celtic. They were impressive. They did play well. Robbie Winters did pull a goal back in the second half, but it mattered little by that stage. Aberdeen, distinctly unimpressive. And this was different class. Celtic victors by 5-1.
It was four very good goals, and that one Jim was a wee bit unfortunate with the second goal. It's 4 good goals. Tommy's obviously got a hat trick, which is great for him and great for us, because if there's a player in your team that scores a hat trick, then you're going to have a fair old chance of winning the game. There's also a couple of instances where the young players have done well.
Yeah, but from an Aberdeen point of view, that was surely dreadful.
Yeah, especially first half, I would say, but yeah, they could have scored a couple of goals more obviously in the second half, I think. But second half, we created a couple of chances to make it look a little better.
But it just looked like no contest for most of the match.
Yes, I must admit that.
Is that soul-destroying for you to have to watch that?
It's never fun to see that you are being outplayed in at least the most of the game. It's not very nice to see, but that's the way it was today, and something we have to correct.
It wasn't much of a contest today, but Berkovic and Maravcic ripped Aberdeen apart, really, didn't they?
Well, when they two are on below, it takes a good team to stop them. They're two very, very talented players. Iowa hasn't scored, but he's played particularly well, and they both scored a couple. His second goal was a brilliant goal for the viewer stand. I know it was on television, but it's not meant to be in that with him. He's a very, very talented player. Lubo's, I suppose, I'm only telling everybody what they already know. But when they two play, then it's difficult to stop.
Do you worry about competing with Rangers in 3 weeks' time when you look at that?
Yeah, I do. But we'll have to correct that as much as possible. We have played even games with Rangers earlier, so it should be possible to do that again. But we have to perform a lot better than we did today.
This nice competition, Henrik's on his way back, you know, that's an added bonus. He trained for the first time the other day, so hopefully, I don't know what the scenario is for him towards the end of the season. Big Marco's been brilliant, you know, 20-odd goals. And we've got young Birchie, everyone's still to remember that Birchie's only 19, he's still got a lot to learn, but his goals per game ratio is tremendous, and me as well, so there's like four.
You're not bad either.
Well, yeah, I'm just glad to be playing, to be honest, but yeah, there's competition. Obviously, the new man's going to come in and he'll have his own view, so it'll probably be down to him in the end.
So you've got a lot to do in the next 3 weeks?
Oh, yeah.
Thanks for it.
There's been a lot to do the whole year, and there will still be next year as well.
And those 23 goals conceded